Okay, everyone, super excited because I got my beta license for Vray 5 this morning, and I'm testing it out a little bit, and I want to do one of my first look videos. I haven't fully explored everything, but I've found some stuff that's so awesome that I want to put a video out right away and show you some of the things that are going to be available, first of all with the beta, but then hopefully with the finished version as well. Stay tuned for one of the things that they added that I think is the coolest thing they've added in a long time. I love this new feature. So stick with me here for a second. Some of the big things that they have. So just in short, it's material library and browser. They've added a material library, which is super cool. If I bring my material editor over here and I'm just using an old scene from one of my courses, which you can get for free in my course if you check out the links below. Okay, so the material library that comes with Vray, there's a special browser for it, but I want to look at mostly the materials that come, and it's basically a bunch of files, mat libraries for 3ds Max, which we're probably used to. But if you, when you download Vray, it'll come with a Vray material library downloader, and there's a bunch of files, .mat files, and this is just basically telling it where to go. So you can pick where you want it on your computer, and then in your material, and you can go through and look at all the JPEG little swatches of it, or use the material browser, but you can also just go here, and this is how you actually use it. You can just go into open material library and go to where you've downloaded them all. Okay, and you can see these are all the different things, and here's the .mat files. So all these different things, like leather, that's cool. Let's bring in the ground one, see what we've got in here. Okay, so asphalt, soil, sand, gravel. Okay, so you can preview all this stuff, or you can just bring it directly in by saying, let's say, asphalt cracked. Okay, and that just brings it into our slot over here. If we preview it, I mean, you guys know how to do all this. The cool thing is that Vray or Chaos Group is giving us a bunch of free materials, which are presumably very nice because they are professionally made, right? So you can see it's inside of a color correction, and then you go in and the map is in here. If we view the image, and it's a Vray bitmap actually. Oh, and interestingly, it's a .tx file. Okay, so a .tx file is a texture file, which is basically a bitmap in TIFF format. So there's a lot of information in each one of these maps. And that's cool. This is high-end material stuff that is made for us by Chaos Group, and you can just pop it right in. So I can grab this library and just drag this and put it right here. I'm not going to do that because I don't want asphalt there. But I did bring in this brick. We could try that. Right now I've got a concrete on there, which I'm going to grab. Oh, one thing you might notice is that the previews for the materials are also new. So this is one of the updates for Vray 5, is that these are presumably a better preview of what the materials are. And I think that's a much needed change, actually. That's great. Let's grab these bricks and just pop them on here. See what kind of thing we get. Okay, one thing here is they're not real world scale, and you guys know I like to work in real world scale. So we'll have to see what kind of scale we're talking about here. Let's go into the map. Okay, so there's our image basically. We'll say that's 5 feet by 5 feet. Now I would have to change this for every map in the whole thing if I want it to be real world, or I could just remap my surface there. But I'm going to change all the maps. Let me do that real quick. Okay, so we're dealing with a diffuse map, a normal map in the bump slot, and a reflection map. Okay, great. There's our material. Looks fantastic. We'll see how it looks when it renders. Okay, so great. There's that. There's also, in the materials, you'll notice that we now have presets in here, which is awesome. I mean, right here is preset. It's custom right now. I can, let's make a copy of this and say, let's make this into a preset. One of the ones I saw that I liked was frosted glass. Okay, how many times do you make frosted glass just over and over? Okay, and actually that's gonna freeze up my video card. Give it a second. Okay, so my computer's freaking out because I put frosted glass on this huge swatch here and I'm recording at the same time. All very bad. But point is, it changed to frosted glass. It's still keeping my maps, interestingly, so that's kind of weird in this case. If we just delete, okay, and now we can just go straight to a lead preset. All right, So this is cool. I haven't fully explored what we've got down here, but this is new. Coat parameters. So we have coat amount, coat roughness. So presumably you could put a coat on this thing. Make it. So this is kind of like I used to use the shellac, maybe. Something like that. Okay, so you can see there's a coat on top of the metal, and you can change the index of refraction just for that. Okay, you can lock the coat, bump to the base, bump to base bump. Okay, so this is almost like having another material on top of material, kind of like the flake, the auto paint material, or the V-Ray paint material, that kind of stuff. Okay, and then there's sheen parameters. Not exactly sure how to use this yet. So more testing necessary there. Okay, but you can put a coat on this, which is cool. And these presets are very cool because I make this stuff over and over and over again because I'm not good about saving out material libraries or anything like that. So having it just here as ready-made could be extremely helpful for me. Okay, now let's get to my favorite thing. There's a new frame buffer, which is cool, but not that big a deal. I mean, it's got the same settings. So let's see, frame buffer. Show last frame buffer. Okay, so the frame buffer looks different now, which is fine. Basically all the same kind of stuff here, but it looks a little different. It's in different places. Okay, the biggest thing that I think is this, let's see. Well, here's your lens effects, denoiser, splay correction. So here's your exposure control. Great. But if you turn on this new render element, V-Ray Light Mix, then you have great control over what you're trying to do. So if I render this. Let's just render. We save first. Okay, you can see it's starting to render. We're in the light cache phase. I've had to turn the exposure way down for this. The cool part's still coming. Hang on a second. Give it a minute. Okay, this is a pretty complex rendering with a lot of blur going on, so it's taking a really long time. So I just aborted it. You can see I'm missing materials, but that's not the point of the video. That's just because I recently updated Max and didn't remap everything, but that's fine. We can see everything we need to see here. So up here we have a layer stack now, more like Photoshop. So we can apply a layer, so like white balance on top. Okay, we can adjust the white balance here and we can change the opacity of it, which is awesome. Blend mode, we can change to whatever we want. Okay, so awesome, a lot more like Photoshop here. We can do compositing right here in the frame buffer. That is super cool. But the coolest thing, I think, we still have our lens effects here. We have denoiser available if we add it as a render element here. Okay, so that we saw denoiser in previous versions. But here, if we go to source RGB, we can go to light mix. Okay, this is awesome. So here we can turn off all the lights just like that. But we can also control every light individually. So this light gets turned off. That's the environment light, obviously. We can also turn it up or higher. Okay, make it super bright outside, or make it darker. Let's see, which one's this? I don't know, I got a lot of lights in this scene, but I can control each one of them individually. Okay, you can see there's a lamp inside the house that's getting way brighter now. I mean, that is so cool. And I realize, look at that. Through the glass, everything, that light's turning up. So what this is doing is essentially rendering out a channel for every light that's like an EXR image or an HDR image of some kind so that you can multiply it up and down and it affects the scene differently and they're all split out into different channels. And I know like Maxwell Render had this a long time ago and I thought it was the coolest thing ever. And V-Ray had the capability too, but it was a lot more clunky than this. You had to render out a different element for every light, and then you could composite it yourself like that in Photoshop, but now it's just built into here, and it's super easy to use. So this is awesome. This will save me so much time of preview rendering, because really all you gotta do is get the lights in there, and then you can just adjust them, tweak them, until they're just perfect, and you don't have to re-render every time. It's amazing. And it's super accurate too, like everything just looks like you would expect. It's not getting all super noisy and bad quality or anything. It just works. So this is amazing to me. I'm so glad they did this. Look at that. You can just turn the pool up. I mean, come on. That is a huge improvement. So this is what I like to see from these software developers. I mean, so often they just release, and I'm not saying Chaos Group does this, Autodesk, no comment. But they release things that just aren't that big of an improvement, right? This is a huge improvement. I'm going to buy it just for this one thing here. And the material library is huge too. I love that. And the presets. That's great. So I haven't explored everything yet, but from what I can see here, this is worth the money of upgrading. And I don't even know what the cost is going to involve, but I'm definitely getting this because this is a huge time saver and it gives you tons of creative freedom to basically just get your lights in there and then from there just adjust them to your heart's content, and you can balance light so easily this way and make your renderings just look fantastic without having to render a million previews. Anyway, that's my first look at V-Ray 5, and I think this is going to be huge. I think we're all going to want this. And they have, I mean, I haven't even fully explored what they're going to do, and they keep saying they're going to add, you know, there's going to be more new stuff involved. I'm just briefly going over the things that they mentioned, and I checked out this one thing, and I had to tell you guys about it immediately because it's awesome. Okay, so I love this new compositing here. I absolutely love this light mix thing. Oh, and you can also do composite mode by doing this to composite. Okay, and what that does is put your light mix in a huge list of layers. Okay, so then you can just turn on and off layers. So work it just like Photoshop. I mean, this is how you had to do it manually before, and it sucked, honestly. It was too much work. But this is really just built in and so easy. And then you can even go back to light mix if you want, just like that. Okay, so it collapses the layers into this light mix thing. So it's just two different interfaces for the same thing. Anyway, guys, I think this is fantastic. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and hopefully I can make more stuff as more stuff becomes available. And as I learn more about Vray 5.0, I think we're all gonna love this. So anyway, I'm excited. Hopefully you guys are too. Thanks for watching.